This video is brought to you by Clean My Mac X. I've been using Mac OS Monterey for a while now, and although some of the key features that I'm interested in might not be out by the time you watch this video, here are those that matter to me and actually make a difference in my workflow. And let's just warm up with the fact that you can now place a Memoji on your lock screen, and not just a static one, but an animated one. Now that's just too awesome to miss. Your Memoji interacts with you as you type your passwords. For the first time ever, you might want to spend some time entering the wrong passwords because the unsuccessful attempts are just too hilarious to watch. To set up your custom Memoji, all you have to do is go to Settings, Users and Groups, and edit your user's profile picture. You can also use the settings screen to edit and create new Memojis, since you might find it easier than doing that on your phone. Alright, now back to real life, where FaceTime is the key feature that might make a difference for many working from home. I am talking about the ability to invite people into a FaceTime call using a web link that can be shared. That of course is tightly integrated with the calendar too, and with the ability to join a FaceTime call via the web browser, Apple is undoubtedly increasing the potential of the app. I already used it a few times with colleagues of mine, and it appears to be working seamlessly. Creating a calendar event for a call couldn't be simpler. One can join a call from any device, and even multiple devices for that matter. Picture quality and sound quality are excellent, especially for whoever is using an iPhone or an iPad. Compared to Zoom, it's a lot less fun and gimmicky. Still, the overall quality of the experience is definitely better because aside from the better picture quality, voice isolation is now baked into FaceTime. With it, you can have a vacuum cleaner running in the background and still conduct a decent and natural conversation.
Alright, so now we're testing voice isolation on Mac OS Monterey. Now we are talking without any noise in the background, but right in this moment we're gonna turn the noise up actually, which is a vacuum cleaner. And by now, and you should be able to hear me just right. And I can't even imagine how you can conduct a conversation in a way where you have somebody cleaning with a vacuum cleaner behind you, but... Can you still hear me, by the way?
Actually, pretty good, yeah. I can hear it perfectly.
Nice. Okay, so let's talk about those reports from last time and how much money we've made.
Unfortunately, I can't test and experience SharePlay since it's not officially released yet. It is the feature that stands behind watching and listening to music and TV with people. In the topic of meetings, it also enables desktop sharing. Also, portrait mode or the blurred out background is definitely something that benefits all people on a call, as I mentioned in my iOS 15 video, which I released recently. In that same video, I tried to explain and showcase how spatial audio works. I'm saying this because spatial audio is now part of Mac OS Monterey as well. If you want to see my attempt at explaining it, you can check out my iOS 15 features video up there or in the description below. Spatial audio works almost everywhere in Monterey, and it has honestly spoiled me tremendously. It's fantastic during FaceTime calls too because it spreads out the sound in a way that it's coming from the direction in which the participants are positioned during that call. Meanwhile, AirPlay on the Mac is finally here, and it's one of those features that should have existed for a long time now. Just as you can AirPlay content from your iPad or iPhone to your TV or Apple TV, you can now throw a video or presentation to your Mac or to any other Mac in the network for that matter. This is very cool for a few reasons. First of all, if you collaborate with people in an office, you can go to someone's desk and share a video, music or presentation on the fly. Second, if you're like many people who don't have a TV but instead use a decent sized monitor at home to work and entertain, you can do that even better now. While on the topic, you can mirror your Apple devices on the Mac as well. This is also a great way to use your Mac as a speaker destination. Since I have hooked external speakers, I can simply transfer over my playlist for everyone to enjoy from any corner of the studio. Quick Note is a welcomed feature that is very similar to what people will get with iPadOS 15. Dragging the mouse to the bottom right corner of the screen hints at a quick blank note that expands to a small window for easy and quick access when scrolled further. Accessing it, by the way, works from everywhere, and even in full screen and split view and even in gaming. And to be honest, at first I didn't know about this feature, and my accidental mouse corner bumps that led to the hint of the quick note made me think that this was some sort of a glitch. Anyway, this is a handy feature for me, and it kind of reminds me of the stickies, which are still here in Monterey and still that dated looking. Aside from what I have experienced so far, dragging the mouse to the corner does not create a quick note every time, but instead pulls out the current quick note, which is better than generating a new note every time. This feature, combined with the new hashtag system, allows for very easy navigation and location of scrap notes, which is something that I struggled to clean a few days ago, since I had tons of random notes with weird titles that meant nothing to me. Oh, and to dig deeper, I can now highlight stuff in Safari to add to Quick Note, which is just incredible. When I get to the highlight that I have created later, the Quick Note hints me from the corner about the relation. And by the way, if you end up enjoying this video, subscribe, because I'm losing my voice. Now let's talk about iCloud Plus, which offers handy new features, one of which is Hide My Email. This feature can be found on iOS 15 as well, but now in Monterey, you can customize it. With Hide My Email, Apple gives you the option to protect yourself by creating email aliases to hide your personal email when you want to log in or sign up on websites that you wouldn't personally trust. For example, you can create and label an alias junk and use that alias whenever you want to. This means that you can say goodbye to all your other junk Gmail email addresses and handle everything with clever aliases. Next is one feature that I've always admired on all the iPhones: erase all content and settings. Well, now that feature has arrived on the Mac as well, and here's how it works. Whenever you're selling your Mac or simply switching to another one, you no longer need to go through all the cumbersome steps of formatting and reinstalling Mac OS. Instead, you can merely erase all content and settings, which will securely clean all the information except for the operating system. This setting lives in system preferences. It guides you through the safe deletion of everything: Touch ID, settings, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and more. But what if you don't want to erase everything and instead get rid of stuff that only slows down and clogs your Mac? Today's video sponsor, CleanMyMacX, can help with that. It is a beautifully designed app that is trusted by millions of users worldwide, including me. CleanMyMacX is the ultimate Mac cleaning utility that declutters your Mac. Smart Scan is CleanMyMacX's most prominent feature, and for a good reason. With a simple press of a button and a few seconds later, Smart Scan examines the Mac system for log files and user cache that is no longer needed. Another favorite feature of mine is Space Lens, which gives me a glimpse at what files are taking most of my disk space. On the verge of upgrading to macOS Monterey, you might need to clean up some space for the over 11 gigs of installation files, and CleanMyMacX can help you do exactly that. Be sure to check out CleanMyMacX by clicking on the first link in the description below. So, by far, the most helpful feature and perhaps the most impressive one for me is Live Text, which is integrated throughout the operating system. Besides the Photos app, this feature works in other native apps like Preview, which is just priceless. Let me give you the perfect example of this feature. The other day, my finance agency had sent me a scanned notary document that I had to recreate and notarize again. Now, in the old days, I would have to retype this document by hand because it's very specific, and I would have to spend some serious time making sure all the structure was on point. Now, with Live Text, all I have to do is this. This is just absurd. Of course, it might have some hiccups and it might mess up some words, but the time it can save is just ridiculous. Now, minor mistakes are mainly determined by the quality of the scan and the photo and the font used, by the way. So I also like to point out a couple of honorable mentions that you might not hear elsewhere unless you dig into the fine print. Okay, You can now customize your mouse pointer, specifically the outline and fill color, and finally make it a wacky color that matches your mousing moods. See, I found a reason to use my patented mousing word again. Next up is my new favorite screensaver introduced in Mac OS Monterey called Hello. It comes in three different variants, and honestly, it's mesmerizing to enjoy even from a distance. I say enough is enough with the flip clock. If you enjoyed this video, you might find my recently released iOS 15 video where I talk about features that actually make a difference in my daily life useful. As always, it's been an absolute pleasure. This is Z. Oh, by the way, if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comment section below or ping me on Twitter. Over and out.